and today my topic is redox reaction. First is oxidation. We have to discuss oxidation and reduction first. So what is oxidation? Addition of oxygen or electronegative, because oxygen is negative charge, have negative charge, that is why electronegative element. So here when C combined with O2, they form CO2, and it is the oxidation of carbon, because carbon get attached to oxygen. Here Mg is attached to chlorine, so here oxidation of chlorine take place. Here carbon monoxide react with O2, so oxidation of carbon monoxide take place. Here sulfur is react with O2, so oxidation of sulfur take place. Second definition of oxidation is removal of hydrogen or electropositive, because hydrogen is positive charge, so electropositive element. Here H2S when react with Cl2, it forms 2HCl and S, that is oxidation of hydrogen sulfide take place. Here HCl, MnO2 react with each other, so here oxidation of hydrogen chloride take place. Here methane get oxidized with oxygen to form CO2 and water, so oxidation of methane take place. It is potassium ferrocyanide, so oxidation of potassium ferrocyanide take place in this reaction with the help of H2O2, that is hydrogen peroxide. The substance which provide oxygen or to remove hydrogen is called oxidizing agent. For example, in this reaction, O2 is oxidizing agent because it provide oxygen to C. Similarly, in the reaction, H2S and Cl2, Cl2 is an oxidizing agent because it removes hydrogen from hydrogen sulfide. That is why it act as a oxidizing agent. Now come to reduction. Addition of hydrogen or electropositive element. Chlorine when react with H2, it forms 2 molecule of HCl, that is reduction of chlorine take place. Here H2S when react with Cl2, it forms HCl and S, reduction of chlorine take place again. When mercury dichloride and tin dichloride react with each other, they form mercury 2Cl2, SnCl4, that is reduction of HgCl2. Vegetable oil when react with hydrogen, it forms ghee, that is why it is reduction of vegetable oil take place. Now next definition of reduction is removal of oxygen or electronegative element. So here copper oxide when react with carbon take oxygen with from copper and form carbon monoxide. In this way it reduce the copper. Now next reaction is Fe2O3 when react with H2. This H2 take away oxygen from Fe, so it reduce Fe. Here also carbon take oxygen from zinc, so it reduce zinc. Carbon reduce zinc, so reduction take place. Here also Cl2 taken away with the hydrogen, so here reduction of FeCl3 take place because it becomes FeCl2 after removing one chlorine. The substance which provide hydrogen or remove oxygen is called reducing agent. For example, H2S and Cl2 gives 2HCl and S, so hydrogen sulfide is a reducing agent because it provide hydrogen to chlorine in the reaction. Again, next reaction is copper oxide and carbon. Copper take away the oxygen from, carbon take away the oxygen from copper and reduce it. So the carbon is reducing agent. This act as a reducing agent because it reduce copper by taking away the oxygen to form cupric oxide, to remove oxygen from cupric oxide. Now what is redox reaction? The reaction in which oxidation and reduction process occur simultaneously are referred to as redox reaction. For example, in this reaction, HgCl2 is undergoing reduction. This undergoing reduction because here Hg2 is here and Hg1 is here. So it just undergo reduction because an electropositive element Hg is being added to that side. Now here tin chloride is undergoing oxidation because an electropositive element Cl is being added to it, and it called redox reaction because both the reduction and oxidation take place in one reaction only. So my question is for today, what is oxidation, reduction and redox reaction? Thank you.